by fire and light is lasting.
Thank you. Thank you. wife is a fortunate man. He will live twice long because of her. A fine wife is a joy to her husband. And he can live out all his years in peace. A beautiful wife is a blessing given to him by God. Whether such men are poor or rich, they will be happy and look cheerful. A gracious wife is her husband's delight. Her ability makes him a stronger man. A wife who doesn't talk too much is a gift from the Lord. A modest wife is her husband's. A modest wife has endless charm. It is a quality too precious to measure. The beauty of a good wife is in her well-kept home. It's like the noonday sunshine in the Lord's sky. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to the Lord.
Selfish or irritable.
Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love is not happy with evil, but is happy with the truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, hope, and patience never fail. The world.
If you lose your faith, you have lost everything.
our belief. We find for good God for ourselves spiritually. And then he teach me one of the greatest commandments. Time when some rich young man can ask Jesus, say, where did he feel?
Joseph and Adeline, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community. Christ above and beyond blesses the Lord. He has already consecrated you in baptism and now enriches you and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Joseph and I shall now ask you to freely undertake the occasion of marriage and to state that there is no legal impediment to your marriage. Are you ready and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
I am.
Are you ready to love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
I am.
Are you ready to continue to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the laws of Christ and His church?
I am.
I do solemnly declare that I, Lucas Joseph, Lord, love you. I do solemnly declare that I know not of any lawful impediment. Why I am proud to say, Safia may not be joined in holy matrimony to Yahweh and the name.
I do solemnly declare that I know not of any form of impediment. Why I, Yahweh and the name, may not be joined in matrimony.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I ask you now to join your right hands, declare your consent before God and His church. Look on Joseph, Safia. Will you take Yange Adeline Yige here present for your lawful wife according to the right of our mother, Holy Church?
I will.
But God has joined together, then man, no man with the son.
Yange Adeline Yige, will you take look on Joseph? Safia here present for your lawful wife according to the right of our Holy Mother, the Church.
I will.
What the Lord has joined together, let no one put asunder.
I call upon these people here present to witness that I become chosen. Do take thee, Yange Adonai, to be my lawful wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, to obey to us.
May the Lord bless these rings, which give to each other as the sign of your love and fidelity. Amen. God, be the Father Almighty, dear brothers and sisters. May every prayer, especially for one like Joseph, of our heart be directed us. For it's will it is that all humanity should be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth.
Our response is, hear our prayer. Let us pray for the church and especially its leaders, that may the Lord continue to give them the strength to spread the word of God to all the ends of the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For the newly wedded, we pray for Joseph and Adeline, joined in matrimony. Lord, bless and seal this union with hearts that cannot be broken. Father, bless them with wisdom and understanding, and bless and bring them to old age together. Lord, in your mercy.
Strength. Give prayers to the church. For you. Please, communion now for Catholic women who don't prepare themselves.
Thank you very much. I'm sure Joe and Adeline are very happy. We pray that this population will follow us there so that we continue to be in this happiness with them. Thank you very much and have a nice day.
Sisters, since I'm not the master of ceremony for this occasion, I am not going to go through the normal protocols. I will not go to the normal protocols that I normally go to this kind of day. I'm just up here on this very special assignment. But before I go into that subject matter, permit me to say a few words to our priests who are here today. I want to thank especially the many celebrants for the ring from that. Remy and myself will be high school together. The last time I saw him, he was not yet a priest. That is so many years back. But he is now one of the pillars of the church. And I must take this opportunity to thank him for coming to me. The second thanks will go to Father Paul. I remember Father Paul for two things. I met him when he was just a very young priest. He was coming out, he was just newly ordained. And I met him with my children. And amongst those was chosen. And I remember two things he said on that particular occasion. He said, he's going to ask the Holy Father to excommunicate this young man from the church because he was living in an illegal situation. He was not married. According to the Catholic doctrine. This was also so many years back. And the second thing he said was, I would want to be the minister to get these people into holy matrimony. Reverend, the man is here. And we must thank him for making it all the way from here to here. Any person who has done that road in the past few years, you know what it takes for somebody to come that distance to be part of his occasion. He has kept to his promise. He has made it to the occasion. And for that, we are very thankful. I should also thank my friend Jonas, who has been kind enough to accompany me right from the Central African Republic to hear from his occasion. Now, the reason why I'm up here is because one of our brothers, I would have also liked to be with us here today, Reverend Ellis Hillary, has been kind enough to go to the Vatican to get the Pope's blessing for this young couple. He wanted to be here himself. But for other calendar reasons, he could not make it. And so he commissioned me to hand this Papa blessing. Before I do that, I can read to the congregation what is written on this Papa blessing. It is from the Pope of Pope Francis. It says, the Holy Father Francis cordially imparts the blessing, the apostolic blessing, to Joseph, Nukong, and Adeline Ayie on the occasion of their marriage, with prayers for the happiness of their Christian life together. This is done in Vatican on the second day of December in the year of our Lord 2021.
May God be to our Father, keep
you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home.
Amen.
May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone.
Amen.
May you be witnesses in the world towards charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.